What an odd tournament this has been. I'm John Rentham with my review of New Japan Pro Wrestling's New Japan Cup 2021 Night 9 and 10 events. I was originally going to wait till Thursday and include the Night 11 event in the 3-show review, but there are things I have to vent about, things I have to praise, and I can't wait. There have been things building up in my head that I finally have to vent about, and I've vented about a few of these things briefly in the past, but it's time. It is really time. And I love New Japan. I want to praise them more. And I get that they're trying to do what they can till they get full crowds back, but goddammit, some of these shows have just been repeating like crazy, like mad. And some of the cup matches, like, oh great, more of this shit, more interference, more bullshit. It's getting repetitive and annoying. Let me know your thoughts in the comments, by the way. And the deep tournament field, like, it is a pretty deep field. And you're going to get a few bad matches like they've had, a few decent matches like they've had. Most of the matches have been good to great. A couple of the matches are my favorite matches of the year list. But the undercard matches are just there to hype up the various cup matches and possible feuds in the future, which is the whole point of doing undercard matches, you know, multi-man matches. Anyway, we start off with Kenta, Ishimori, and Jado versus Suzuki, El Desperado, and Doki. Suzuki-gun jumps the bell, and Jado, Gato, and Dick Togo should not be in the ring that much, if at all, anymore. I'm sorry, they shouldn't. Jado can't really move, he's in great shape. Gato, his antics got old a couple years ago. And Dick Togo should stop inserting himself repeatedly in a New Japan ring. It just gets old and it gets stale. Speaking of old and stale, besides Kenta and Gorillas of Destiny, I'm sick of the Bullet Club. It's a t-shirt brand. That's all it fucking is. If you guys like Bullet Club, that's fine. I just don't. And I'm going to vent more about that in a little bit. More Kenta and Suzuki. I'm all for that. Wouldn't mind them, having a match at Sakura Genesis. They had a pretty damn good match in the cup. And Stretch Muffler taps out Jado. Good thing the guy that shouldn't have been in the ring got tapped out. And then we get Suzuki not being done with Kenta, and also the possibility of El Desperado versus Ishimori. That should be good. United Empire with Miss Priestley, who does not need to be there. Yes, that was a pun. I am sick of her. She just yells a ton at ringside, and it's not even a good kind of yelling. She's just like, bitch, shut up. Just shut up. Like, seriously, you add nothing. You add absolutely nothing. I don't mind New Japan incorporating women into their show. I mean, you know, I miss Miho Abe and Peter, or however you say her name. I miss, you know, valets and stuff like that, and I would like to maybe see some women's matches in New Japan, but there are, of course, you know, all women promotions. There's Stardom, there's stuff like that. They have a deal with Stardom, and there's TV deals and stuff like that. I get it, but if Bea Priestley is the best they can do, no, just she's aligned with Ospreay, so I get it. And they're trying to make Ospreay a dominant heel. It's just not good. It's not good at all. It wouldn't matter what company he was part of. They took on Zack Sabre Jr., Taichi, and Kanemaru. The Empire jumps the bell, and B, again, won't shut up. And then Tour of the Islands pins Kanemaru 1-2-3. If nothing else, Jeff Cobb has gotten over way more by being dominant in a lot of these multi-man matches. I wish he had been able to go deeper into the tournament, but he has shined on this tour. And then LIJ versus Nagata, Goto, and Taguchi. I will say I'm glad that Naito and Okada got some time off, and maybe they can get, you know, some kind of medical treatment. Okada's got the bad back. Maybe he can get surgery to take care of that. He's the best in the world, in my personal opinion, but if he doesn't take care of that, the stubbornness is only going to carry him so far. That could damage him longer. Yes, wrestling is a contact sport, but I want them to be able to have long careers, Naito especially with his bad knee, so hopefully they can get that stuff addressed. Pace is good as expected, and the bridge pin pins Taguchi, 1-2-3. And then we get Yoshihashi versus David Finlay in a New Japan Cup match. And they worked hard, and I didn't care. I'm sorry. It's nothing against David Finlay. It's nothing against Yoshihashi. The work rate was there. Juice was in the corner cheering on David Finlay, and I just didn't care. It was what it was. I did like, you know, the chops being laid in and some good strikes and stuff like that. And then eventually, David Finlay hits his finish, 1-2-3, and then his show respect afterwards. The match was fine. It was fine. David Finlay advances. And then we get Tanahashi, the Never Open Champion, against Jay White with Gato. Oh boy. You know, you could literally tune out a half of Jay White's matches and not miss shit. Jay White can wrestle. He can. His antics and everything, the Snoozeblade era, as I'm going to start calling it. And if that pisses people off, that's fine. Because you guys can be fans of Jay White. I find him boring. Unless he's with somebody better than him, which is a bit of a list. He's not going to have a match where I'm going to find it any more than, oh, the same old bullshit. Even though he can hit the moves, he can do the stuff, the character work works well for some, it just doesn't work well for me. Because I don't care. I don't find him to be like this, you know, intimidating guy. Like, oh, he's just kind of there. He beats Tanahashi with the Blade Runner. Pretends to be shocked that Jay White advanced with some interference stuff. If they stop with the interference and just have Jay White, you know, briefly cheat, like, oh, distraction. Oh, you know, he gets him on the ropes and everything and snaps her knee and then hits the Blade Runner. Fine, but the Gato interference is so goddamn played out. Anyway, that was the end of that. I enjoyed the Yoshihashi-David Finlay match. Even though Tanahashi versus Jay White was well-worked, I just didn't care. Gabriel Kidd, Yotsutsuji, and Yuya Yamura versus Tenzan, Kojima, and Nagata. Young versus old. And that's not any disrespect. The Young Lions went after the veterans. Kidd, well, you know, Kidd just would not back down, but eventually did tap out to the crossface. Now, it was a good match. You know, and good showcase. I think Kidd has a very bright future. And then Jay, Chase, and Fale with Gato versus Juice, Finlay, and Hanare. New theme for Juice. It sounded like it was recorded in a dilapidated garage. It was about to be torn down. Hype for Finlay versus Jay, which is a match that will certainly exist. And Grenade pins Hanare. I hope Hanare gets used better. I really hope he does. And I hope Fale maybe steps away before his knees get totally shot. Well, it's Jeff Cobb and Will Ospreay with Miss Priestley. Great, good, good. You know, they've addressed this stuff by adding more B. Priestley, because that's what we all fucking need. They took on Bushi and Sonata. It was just hype for Will versus Sonata, which will be a good match. Zack Sabre Jr. versus Will Ospreay is one of my favorite matches of the year. It was goddamn amazing. Great shit. Great clash of styles. Will did say, because he did get his nose busted, and actually I'm glad he's okay, because that looked really goddamn deadly. He says, "Don't hit me in the face, my nose is broken." Bushi dives on Ospreay with a great torpedo. And then Tour of the Islands pins Bushi later, 1-2-3. And then Sonata flips off Ospreay when he tries to get in his face, like, "You lied, you said you wouldn't hit me in the nose." Will is trying too hard to be a heel here, but I will say at least they're trying to go with it. If he wins the cup, I won't be upset because he'll lose to Ibushi. Though I think Shingo's going to end up winning the damn thing, which I'm not going to be upset about either. So we then get Evil with Dick versus Yano, New Japan Cup quarterfinal. This may be one of the worst matches of the year, and I don't expect, you know, incredible, you know, long matches from Yano. Yano does his comedy, he can do his stuff, and his antics work for short matches. Evil has dramatically dropped in, you know, like, terms of me giving a shit about anything that he does, and it's not even that he's bad. But this stuff with Dick inserting himself constantly, let me tell you right now, when Dick keeps repeatedly inserting himself, you're going to get tired and chafing. Use lube. Moving on. They did the exposed buckle spots, usual shit, and then Dick gets, you know, hit into the guardrail. And then Yano chokes Evil with Dick's very veiny chain, or whatever the hell it is, a Garrett, and then shoves him under the ring, and then Yano's about to win, and then lights out. The laziest thing. That's one of the worst things that Paul Heyman introduced to wrestling. He, you know, the lights go out, and then what the hell happened? Oh, Evil appears from from behind on Yano and hits the, everything is evil. Why was this a thing? It was stupid. It was dumb. It was really dumb. And, yeah, so Evil advances. Cool. All right, that match really didn't accomplish shit. I got no problem with Evil winning because I knew he was going to, but it was dumb. Kenta versus Shingo, New Japan Cup. Look, they worked hard. When Kenta stopped stalling, and I don't mind Kenta stalling because Kenta at least can make it interesting. Kenta can hit some strikes and make me care. Jay White just keeps stalling and just does the same goddamn shit. At least Kenta has a name and I care about Kenta. And Kenta's a good heel and I don't, you know, fall asleep watching, you know, Kenta matches like I do Jay White matches. So anyway, it picked up quickly with some strikes and kicks. Kenta's great heel. It's a DDT on the floor. We get rest holds because he's got to target the neck. Stomp off the top. We get a game over. But to the ropes, Tiger Suplex rollout, pumping bomber. Shingo may be my favorite wrestler of the year. He may eclipse Okada. He has just stepped his goddamn game up this year alone. But he's really just impressed me the last few years. I need to go back and watch more of his Dragon Gate stuff. I saw a couple matches. I was like, goddamn, that guy's been great forever. Double chops, slaps, elbow, they just hit each other with everything. DVD by Shingo, pumping bomber for 2, last of the dragons for 3. And then Evil confronts Shingo, and Dick gets, Shingo's dragon from behind, and they do that and everything. And oh boy, they're doing the same fucking Bullet Club fucking antics. I'm fucking sick of it. It's goddamn it's the same, it's repetitive as any of the stuff that the NWO did in WCW. And here's the thing. That worked when there were bigger ratings and bigger crowds and everything. And New Japan should be above this stuff. It's repetitive. It's annoying. And I don't like it. And I don't even like it because, like, oh, it's great heel stuff. No, it's just lazy. It's really fucking lazy. Anyway, agree, disagree, what I said. Like, share, subscribe, Twitter handle in the description. I'm John Rethlin. I'll see you soon.